In this video, I will explain and demonstrate how to get the homework and how to work on the homework. So we use GitHub Classroom to distribute the homework, which takes some of the work from us to get the homework to you by providing an invite link and also helping with the auto-grading. To use GitHub Classroom, you need a GitHub account. Your homework is a repository, and that's what's going to be looked at when checking the homework and grading the homework. It's worth mentioning that we will submit sample solutions for the homework, but to see them, you need to accept the homework using this accept link, which GitHub Classroom provides. And only those that accepted the homework will see the sample solutions, will be added to the group of people seeing the sample solutions. This is our way of making sure they are not freely available on the internet. Okay, so what is the workflow with GitHub Classroom? Well, it's pretty similar to distributed version control system in general. So we have our local copy of the homework, which we distribute by pushing it to a repository and then creating a link using GitHub Classroom. And then when you click this link, you accept the homework, and this makes a copy for you of your homework. This is still on the internet, so to get that, you need to pull that from the internet to get a local copy. And then when you do the homework, you work on this homework, you make new commits to solve the exercise, you create a new commit, and you need to push that to your repository. And this is then what our auto-grading checks. So please make sure to push everything. Okay, to get the homework, you need a GitHub account. You can do so at github.com. As your GitHub account is like your portfolio for programming, make sure it's something you want others to see. So if you get a job in programming, it's pretty likely your boss is going to look at your name at your repository. So please make sure your repository is something you would like your boss to see, including the name. And if you use your university mail, you get free, unlimited free private repositories. Okay, so we can already click on the first link. This is the link for the first homework. But before that, I want to show you the dashboard for a second. You can reach that at dashboard.cyprog.de. So it's a domain freely available on the internet. Okay, I know it doesn't look pretty, but let's sign in here. So I'm going to sign in as Anne. And now we need to authorize that because it's a GitHub app. And once we did that, it's going to tell me that this user is not in our database yet because Anne didn't accept the first exercise. So the dashboard only makes sense after accepting the homework. So let's do that. GitHub Classroom is also a GitHub app, so we need to also authorize that too. We can do that. It needs some stuff for the auto-grading. And then we're already ready to go. And now GitHub Classroom created a new repository for Anne, and it's available here. So this is now Anne's copy of the repository. So first of all, let's look what files are in this repository. So we have a .github file here. That's not important for you. That's necessary for the automated grading. Then there's a gitignore file, which makes sure, I already explained that you and we don't commit unnecessary stuff. You can simply download these files on the internet and then add stuff manually to that. No binaries, no images, etc. Then there's a README, which contains the task description, which is also rendered by GitHub below here. So this is the content of the README. It's a markdown file. You can look at it raw to get how to make headlines and stuff in markdown. And that's pretty straightforward. Genau. Then there are additional files. Then there's, this here is the bare bone structure of the task you're supposed to solve. So in this first task, like I said, it's simply print hello world. So this is the hello world.py file. The requirements.txt, which is the list of packages you will need in your environment for this task. So normally you don't need to install that, except when Python tells you some sort of module not found error. You don't need to install that if you activate your conda event before, because everything you should need for your homework was already in the environment and is automatically installed. If it shouldn't be, you can always install stuff from the environment using pip by installing it via pip install minus r and then the path to requirements.txt. That will install all the requirements. If you look into that file, you see it's just a list of packages and their versions. First one on the PyTest. And then there's the test underscore something dot py file. And this is the testing file. This is what we and you use to see if the program works as expected. And that is done using PyTest. And PyTest is a really nice tool to check if your program has a behavior and an output as intended. So it's a testing library that's included with Python. And what PyTest does when you execute that command on the terminal is that it will grab all the test underscore something functions and all the test underscore something files, executes them and check for errors. And this checking for errors is by using assertions or checking for other kinds of errors. So in this here, we, for example, use assert prime dot find prime 1 equals 2. So that checks if the result of this method here with this argument equals 2. Okay, so if we run PyTest from the terminal, this is an output we are going to get. So first of all, test session starts, blah, blah. And then we're going to see test prime.py. So in this case, it's for a bonus task from the last year. So there was a test underscore prime.py file in there. And then we see dot. So one test seemed to have passed. Normally it shows a dot when it passed. And F for one test that failed. And then PyTest will list me all the failures. So it will here tell me one failed, one passed. So this is a passing one, this is a failing one. Then PyTest will tell me all the tests that fails. And how does PyTest do that? Well, first of all, it copies a few lines of the testing script. So these four lines, these five lines, are from the testing script in white. So it went into this function. It executed this line, worked, executed this line, worked, and then executed this line. And this is the line where the error is, indicated by the error. And now what PyTest does is it shows me why that went wrong. It tells me this line here, the interpreter reads this as 11 equals 9, where 11 is the result of this weird function at some place on your RAM with the argument 8, where this weird function at some place of your RAM is the function prime.findPrime. So that's really nice because PyTest shows me the stack of what went wrong. So it tells me your prime.findPrime method with the argument 8 returned 11 when it was supposed to be 19. So the 8th prime number is 19 and not 11. So it tells you there's an assertion error. And that's how PyTest works. And as soon as you fix that, it's going to run through and it's going to say pass. So what we want to show you with this is so-called test-driven development. And test-driven development is also used in bigger corporate environments for bigger projects. So what you normally do in test-driven development is your boss tells you how your program is supposed to look like. And from that, you write a failing test. So your boss tells you, I want a program that returns for the eighth, if I ask it for the eighth prime number, it returns a 19. So you write a test that does exactly that without having written any other code yet. And then you write code to make precisely that test pass. And then with that, you go to your boss and say, hey boss, is this what you want? And then your boss will tell you, I also want this behavior. You write a new failing test, you make the test pass, you refactor, and so on and so on. So this is this life cycle. We even remove this refactor part because we are in this case your boss. We give you the failing test and you only need to make this test pass. Okay. PyTest, so this is the way it looks when both, so when it completely passed. So dot dot meaning passed, passed. So both here passed. Okay, let's simply do that for now. I will clone this repository. To clone it, I click on clone and download, clone or download here, and I'm going to copy this URL. I'm going to use SSH because I have provided an SSH key. Normally, if you didn't do that, you can Google how to do that, but if you didn't do that, you're normally going to use HTTPS. And there you have to enter your username and password. So let me git clone this repository. Like I said, I have an SSH key, so I don't need to enter username and password. That's just the password for my key. And now we can change directory to Anne's homework directory. Okay, and if I run PyTest in here, it will give me an error message. In this case, it's a not implemented error. Why is that? Well, let's look at the content of our hello world.py file, and we see, well, for the say hello method, it will simply return a not implemented error. So this is what PyTest also tells me. It executes this say hello function, and in the say hello function, it was not implemented, and then it tells me error, not implemented error. So PyTest fails. Okay, let's work on this homework. How do we work on our homework? Well, first of all, we activate our environment, and then we want to use Jupyter Lab. So let's open Jupyter Lab. There we have opened it. Sorry, it opened it in a weird spot. So now we have this open in Jupyter Lab, and we can simply, this is the directory we were in before, so the 2020 homework 01 Anna Ursula repository. So we can simply open our hello world.py file here, and we can also open a terminal here, and in this terminal we can run PyTest. So we don't need to run PyTest in this terminal, don't need this terminal anymore. It needs to stay open because this is where the kernel, the backend of Jupyter Lab is running, which you see here in your browser. Okay, there are one or two more things I want to show you in PyTest. So once this is the result of your PyTest, your homework will pass. And you simply need to upload it, and then it will pass, hopefully, on the local machine and the remote machine as well. So if you only want to run one test file, you can run PyTest and then the name of the file. If you only want to run one function, you can do that too by running PyTest, name of the file, colon, colon, name of the function. To get longer error messages, you can use PyTest minus very verbose. And to only check if pass or fail, you can use this command. And you can, of course, also combine these arguments. So if we run PyTest minus 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 very verbose here, it won't tell me much more. It tells me here which function it ran. So test hello dot test say hello. It tells me that this failed. And it still gives me this error message. It would be longer if there would be more to say. And I can also run PyTest minus minus tb equals zero, and also very verbose, and that gives me only one line for every single file, for every single function, which it executed. Okay, so let's, oops, again, not that. So let's, okay, this is how to download and work on the homework. We did all of that here. So let's actually do that. I will do that in another window, because you shouldn't see what I'm doing here. It's not too hard. When writing this, you may eventually end up at this stage. And again, this is something I did wrong, because it tells me here, but I, so it returns me that the line mySD, so this test hello, say hello function works, it needs to redirect what we would normally print to the screen to a variable. So this is this getstd out. And now it checks if this, what I'm returning with this function here, is hello world, which it wants to have, and it's not, and you may arrive at this error. And if you get this error, you know you printed something wrong. And so now let's fix that, and let's run PyTest again. And we see our test passed. That's pretty nice. So what we need to do now is we need to git commit minus a minus m print hello world, PyTest passes. And let's look at the state of our repository on GitHub. That's my GitHub. That's on this GitHub. So if we don't push, we see there's no new commit. So we need to push here. So let's git push, enter password, and now it's on Anna's remote repository. Said now it's on Anna's remote repository. And we see now there's a new commit here, so four commits. And if we click on this, we see all the commit history. And what we also see here is the result of our PyTest. So, like I said, it's automatically graded, and GitHub does that using these GitHub actions, GitHub class and does that. And we see here, we can go to the details of that. This is the failing test. So let's look at this, and this will get us here. So the GitHub action, and we can look. This is what the automated grading does internally. So we need to set up stuff. We need to run some actions and check out some stuff. It needs to create a Docker container. But the important part for you is this one education slash auto grading. And this is, if you look at that, you're gonna see this one's test hello world. It needs to install some libraries. But then it runs this PyTest here. And we see now this failed. And what failed? The test hello world function failed, and you get the 0 points. However, this is not the newest one, and this one here works. Okay, now if you see this tick, instead of the cross, you know your test passes. Okay, and now you can also look at this on your dashboard. However, you need to give it like 15 minutes. I can also automatically execute that. So normally the dashboard updates every 15 minutes or so, but I can also do that automatically. Just, I need a second. The server kicked me out there for a second, but if we now refresh our dashboard, now that we have this commit here, we should now see that it works. So you're logged in as Anna Ursula, and you see 10 out of 10 points. And if you look here for the current homework, you can check why you have that one home, and that leads you to the same link at the end. You have full credit, so you get 10 out of 10 points. And this is how it's supposed to look. And if the dashboard doesn't work, don't worry. If this arrow here in the repository is there, then it also counts. But generally, look at the dashboard for information. Okay, and now that we did that, we can close the JupyterLab instance, and we can shut down the server here using Ctrl-C, pressing Y, conda deactivate this environment. If you close that, that's also fine. And that should be it then. All right, so that's the link for the dashboard. I demoed you all of this, and now I'm pretty much done. There's only one last thing, and that is, if we find errors in the homework, then the following situation is going to occur. We find errors, we update them, we push that, we push, so this version updates here, and we have a script that adds this change to all of your repositories. However, now we can't make you pull, and can't force you to pull, and you can't push, because the commits here differ. And what you need to do then is you need to pull the changes from the remote, such that you now have two commits on your local. And if you merge them using git merge, you're going to create a new version. That's the magic of Git, where it merges these two versions smartly and makes a new version of that, a new commit. And that then you can push to the server to be graded. Okay, so make sure that you know that. One last thing I want to say to Git is that Git never deletes or overwrites something from the repository and from the history. Never, except if you use minus minus force. So don't trust any help on the internet that uses minus minus force without really knowing what you're doing. Because otherwise, if you use minus minus force, you could delete stuff. Okay, then I have the screenshots of the presentation here again, because for the people that don't want to look at the videos. And with that, I'm done. Sorry that this got a bit longer than 90 minutes, but I think it's more useful. I mean, if I have a 2-minute video and you don't understand it, you can't install all the stuff, that sucks for you. So I thought a bit longer, and Thursday there's no real practice anyway, because, well, if you got everything to one, you're going to be fine, and you don't need to be there on Thursday. If not, I'm going to refer to this anyway. All right, so that's it for this week. See you next week.